morning to everyone. I am Kunjum Malviya, assistant professor in CAC department in AKGC College. Okay, so today we discuss another topic of data structure, which is a graph. In previous my video, I also discussed what is data structure, types of data structure like state, queue, array. Now, I start a new data structure, which is a graph. Okay. So this is the content of today's lecture. Firstly, we discuss what is graph, then terminology used with graph, types of graph, and next is graph representation technique in a memory. How a graph is representation in memory. We only generate pictorial form, but how in a memory graph representation. There are two methods of representation of graph in a memory: agency matrix and agency list. So let's we start. What is a graph? So graph is a non-linear data structure, consists of vertices and edges. Okay. Previously we learned about different types of data structure like stack, array, queue. All of this is a linear data structure in which all data is stored in a linear, in a sequential form. Like in an array, our data is stored in linear fashion, like 5, 6, 8, 3, 2. But what is a graph? Graph is a non-linear data structure. Non-linear means our data is stored in non-linear manner, not in a sequential manner. Okay. So what is a graph? Graph is a combination of vertices and edges. I give you one example, like here A, B, C, D, and E. All these are vertices. Okay. If we connect them by a line, or we can say that an edge, so this is called a graph. Okay. So what is a graph? Graph is a set of edges and set of vertices. So here G equal to what? A into V. E is a set of vertices. Sorry, E is a set of edges and V is a set of vertices. So graph is a combination of set of edges and set of vertices. So there are many components are used in a graph. So let we discuss one by one. First is vertices. I also explain what is vertices. Vertices means this A, B, C, D, E, and graph vertices. Vertices are the fundamental units of the graph. Sometimes vertices are also known as a node. We can also say that vertex as a node. Every vertex, every node vertex can be labeled or unlabeled. When we discuss in detail what is a graph, so every vertex, what is a graph, or some methods like BFS, DFS in a graph. So we see vertex is labeled or unlabeled. Okay. Now what this is all are vertices. We also say that this is a node. Okay, what is edges? Edges are drawn or used to connect two nodes of the graph. Okay, if we want to connect this node, then we have to use what? Edges. So these edges are called, this connection line are called edges. There are no rules. Sometimes edge are also known as arc. Edge are also called arc. If we connect this B to C, then it is also called arc. Every edge can be labeled or unlabeled. Same like vertices, edge labeled or unlabeled. Here, if we give some value to edges like 5, 6, then this is called labeled. Okay, so edges is labeled or unlabeled. So here, what is conclusion is that what is a graph? Graph is a set of vertices and edges. Okay, V is the set of vertices V1, V2, V3, V4, Vn. Like here in our example, 5, 6, 3, 4 vertex we choose. Okay, E is a set of edges. So E is a E1, E2, E3, E4. this is how we define set of edges and set of vertices. So here some example of graph. See, here 1, 2, 3, 5, 4 is what? Node. And this connection 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, 5, this line is what is called this line? Edges. Okay. So, graph, this is a simple representation graph. Graph is many type of graph like undirected graph, directed graph and weighted graph. So, this is undirected graph. Okay. Undirected graph means what? There is no direction. There is no direction of edges between the nodes. There is no direction of edges. It's simply our graph is connected by the line. G to A, A to C, C to D, these to C, C to F, C to B. These are all connected, but no direction in this graph is present. So this is called undirected graph. And what is the second graph? Second graph is directed graph. Here edges must have the one direction. One direction to connect to another node. Okay. Here, like I give example, A to G is connected by one edges and direction of this edges A to G. Okay. And one graph is connected to the one node B to F is connected. Direction of edges this. So here is direction are given in a directed graph. Undirected graph is no direction and directed graph is direction is present of any edges. Third one is weighted graph. What is a weighted graph? Okay. So here you see one difference. Here we mark some numbering to the edges. Okay. We give some values to the edges. Like here B to C 22.2. F to C 16.0. So if one edge contains some numeric value, if one edge is in a graph, if edges contain some numeric value, then we call this is a weighted graph. Okay. You give some numeric value to the edges. So this is weighted graph. Undirected graph, directed graph and weighted graph. Direction, no direction of edges, direction of edges and here edges have some numeric value. So here we discuss about types of graph. Okay. So first one is null graph. What is null graph? A graph is known as a null graph if there are no edge in the graph. Okay. No edge in the graph means only we have vertex. 1, 3, 4 and 5. Only we have what? Vertex. So no edges is there here. So what is this type of graph is called null graph. The second one is travel graph. What is travel graph? Graph having only single vertex. It is also the smallest graph possible. Okay. Only one vertex. If in our graph only one vertex is present, then what is called travel graph. Okay. And third one is undirected graph, which I previously discussed. A graph in which edge do not have any direction. A graph in which edge do not have any direction is called what? Undirected graph. That is the node or unordered pair in the definition of every edges. Okay. Now, second one is, fourth one is directed graph. A graph in which edge has a direction. So this is called directed graph. That is the node or ordered pair in the definition of every edges. In a direction graph, we have a direction of any edges. Okay. We have direction of edges. So nodes are ordered pair in the definition of every edges. So next is what? Fifth one is connected graph. Okay. The graph in which from one node we can visit any other node in the graph is also known as a connected graph. Agar aap ek node se kisi bhi node pe ja pa rahe ho, then what we say? This type of graph is connected graph. Like if we stay here in 3 node. Then from 3, we can move from the 1, 3 to 5, any other node. Then it is called connected graph. This is an example of connected graph. All nodes are connected by what? Edges. Sixth one is disconnected graph. The graph in which at least one node is not reachable from a node is known as a disconnected graph. Means our graph is connected, but in which at least one node is present which is not reachable by you, okay, by any vertex. This is called disconnected graph. Like by example, 3 to 2 connected to 5, 1 connected to 4. But if you want to go 1 from the 3, you can't reach. Okay. 5, if you want to go from 5 to 4, you can't go because there is no connection is available. Okay. So this is what? Disconnected graph. You may go from 3 to 5, 5 to 3, 1 to 4, 4 to 1. But it is not, there is path exist between 5 to 4. So there is, you can't reach, this is not reachable. Okay. Now another graph is regular graph. The graph in which the degree of every vertex is equal to k is called k-regular graph. So what is regular graph? Regular graph, if every vertex have same adjacent, if every vertex have same adjacent, same neighbor, then this called a regular graph. So see here, 3 have same adjacents 5 and 1. One vertex has same adjacents, vertex 3 and 4. 5 vertex have same adjacents, means neighbor 3 and 4. So this is what? 2 regular graph, because all node have a same two neighbor or same two adjacents. That's why we called here k regular graph. K means what? 2, because here every node connected to the same other adjacents. 3 is connected to 2, 1 is connected to 4, connected to the 5 and 1, 2 adjacent. Okay. Next is what? Complete graph. The graph in which from each node there is an edge to each other node. Then it is a club. It is called a what? Complete graph. Okay. So here is the example of a complete graph. See, 3, 5, 1, 4. Each node connected to each other node. Every node to connect it to the other node. Means what is complete graph? Complete graph mein kya hoga? Ki har node jo hai, each node, wo jitne bhi other node hai, un sab se connected hoga by the help of edges. 3 is also connected to 5, 4 and 1. 4 is connected to the 5, 3, 1. Every node connected to the every other node in a graph is called complete graph. Okay. If aap kisi bhi node se agar sare node pe ja sakte ho, if possible hai ki ek node se aap graph mein jitne bhi node available hai un pe agar aap ja sakte ho, it is reachable, then it is called what? Complete graph. So a complete graph with n vertices has n minus 1 two edges. See, here is how many vertex? Here is 4 vertex. So we easily calculate how many edges in a complete graph by the formula n minus 1 divided by 2 edges. See, here is what? 4 vertex. So value of 4 is, so value of n is 4. 4 minus 1 divided by 2. So what? 4 into 3 divided by 2, that is 12 by 2, and the value is 6. So how many edges is present in a complete graph? If we have vertex 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, then how many edges is present? 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So this is the formula. There are six edges is present. If a graph have a 10 vertex, then we easily calculate how many edges in a complete graph. We put the value of n is 10. So we take eraser here. So here we take value 10, 10 minus 1 divided by 2, that is 10 into 9 divided by 2, that is 90 divided by 2, which is answer is 45. So if vertex is 10, then we have a 45 edges. Okay. So next is cycle graph. Okay, the graph is a cycle in itself, the degree of each vertex is 2. Okay, means a cycle graph. If a graph form a cycle, then what is called? This is a cycle graph. Now, what is cyclic graph? A graph containing at least one cycle is known as a cyclic graph. See here, a graph which is not fully cycled, but at least one cycle is present here, then what is called cyclic graph. Okay. Next one is directed acyclic graph. Acyclic graph means there is no cycles present in a graph. It's called acyclic graph. See here. Directed acyclic graph. This is a direction. All edges in this graph have a direction. But there is no cycle in this graph. How it is? Because you can move from 3 to 1, but not 1 to 4. Why? Because direction is opposite. If direction is like that, then you can form a cycle. You can form a cycle. But here is also direction is opposite. So this is not make one a cycle. In this graph, there is not present any cycle. 3 to 1, you can go, but not 1 to 4. 3 to 5, you go, but not 5 to 4. So, this is the direction present of edges, but direction a cyclic graph. Next one is a biparty graph. A graph in which vertex can be divided into two sets, such that vertex in each set does not contain any edge between them. Means what? Biparty graph, here we have two sets of vertices, U and V. Number of vertices written here and number of vertices present here. But vertex, what it says here? Vertex in each set does not contain any edges between them. Ek set mein, jo ye vertex hain, inke beech mein koi edges nahi ho. Okay, so this is called what? Biparty graph. So next one is what? Weighted graph. A graph in which the edges are already specified with weighted. Then this is called weighted graph. Weighted graph can be further classified as directed weighted graph and undirected weighted. I also explained weighted graph means a graph in which edges have some numeric value. Then this is called what? Weighted graph. Now tree versus a graph. Okay, so we also discuss in my previous lecture that tree is also non-linear data structure and graph is also non-linear data structure. So what the difference between tree and a graph? Okay, so see, tree is also non-linear data structure and graph is also non-linear data structure. So there are the restricted type of graph just with some more rules. Every tree will always be a graph, but not all graph will be tree. Means what? कि जितने भी tree हैं, वो क्या हो सकते हैं? Graph हो सकते हैं. पर graph सारे graph tree नहीं हो सकते. ठीक है? So some condition is there why all graph is not a tree. Okay. But every tree is a graph. Okay. So a graph is a tree if it has a two property. एक graph को हम आप tree कभी कह पाओगे जब कुछ प्रॉपर्टीज वो फॉलो करे. फर्स्ट वन इज इट इज अ कनेक्टेड. सबसे पहले तो क्या होना चाहिए? कनेक्टेड. देन सेकंड वन इज देयर आर नो साइकिल इन द ग्राफ. ग्राफ में कोई भी साइकिल नहीं होना चाहिए, तभी आप उसे क्या बोलोगे, ट्री. ग्राफ इज कॉल्ड ट्री इफ इट इज कनेक्टेड एंड देयर आर नो साइकिल इन द ग्राफ. सी दिस ग्राफ इज ट्री, वी कैन चेक बाय दिस टू प्रॉपर्टी. इट इज कनेक्टेड, यस इट इज कनेक्टेड, ऑल नोड आर कनेक्टेड. ओके सेकेंड वन इज देयर आर नो साइकिल इन द ग्राफ. इस ग्राफ में कोई साइकिल नहीं होना चाहिए, बट हियर साइकिल इज प्रेजेंट. See, all nodes are connected and make one cycle. So this graph is not a tree. Okay. If we connect this like a graph, so this graph is also called tree. How? It is connected. First condition, yes, it is connected. Now second condition is what? There are no cycle in the graph. See, these are not making any cycle. These are not making any cycle. So this graph is also called what? Tree. So not every graph is a tree, but every tree is a graph. Okay, so we discuss next. So next terminology in a graph is what? Degree of a vertex. What is the degree of a vertex? The total number of edges linked to vertex is called its degree. एक वर्टेक्स से कितनी एजेस लिंक है उस वर्टेक्स की क्या कहलाएगी? डिग्री. उस वर्टेक्स के हम क्या कहेंगे? डिग्री. सपोज वी टेक वन एग्जांपल ऑफ ग्राफ दैट इज ए बी सी डी एंड ऑल आर दिस कनेक्टेड. सो जो वर्टेक्स ए है उससे कितने नोड कितनी एजेस कनेक्टेड है? थ्री. तो डिग्री ऑफ दिस वर्टेक्स इज व्हाट? थ्री. बी से कितने कनेक्टेड एजेस? टू. सो डिग्री ऑफ दिस वर्टेक्स इज टू. डी की वो डिग्री क्या है? टू, बिकॉज टू एजेस आर कनेक्टेड. एंड सी की डिग्री क्या है? थ्री, बिकॉज दिस थ्री एजेस इज कनेक्टेड. सो डिग्री ऑफ वर्टेक्स इज द टोटल नंबर ऑफ एजेस लिंक टू वर्टेक्स इज कॉल्ड द डिग्री ऑफ वर्टेक्स. सो इन डिग्री और आर क्लासिफाइड इन डिग्री एंड आउट डिग्री. वॉट इज इन डिग्री एंड आउट डिग्री? ओके so in degree, so in degree is, so in degree means if edges is incident to a node is called a in degree, one is going from the node is called a out degree. Okay, so this is the degree of a vertex. A vertex has only outgoing edges and no incoming edges, this is called source. Okay, what is source? If one vertex has a what? Only outgoing edges, like this, only outgoing edges, not incoming edges, is called source. A vertex have only incoming edges. If a vertex have only incoming edges, then it is called what? Sink. When in degree of a vertex is 1 and out degree is 0, then such vertex is called a pendant vertex. Okay. When the degree of vertex is zero, then it is called a isolated vertex. Means this, no edges connected to this vertex is called what? Isolated vertex. Okay. Thank you very much.